Here, I'll push it. Ready? Mark, get set.
Go!
We spend so much of our time as parents wishing we could make the hurt go away.
Is that fun?
Yeah.
7 winters ago, a little girl in swim goggles taught us that pain can actually be one of life's greatest gifts. 3 years old when she took that spill in her garage, Gabby Gingras never felt it. Gabby was born with a rare condition that left her with no sensitivity to pain.
Ah, honey, you can't do that. You'll hurt your head.
She was also blessed with oodles of attitude.
I'll have to take your milk because we're not supposed to have the chocolate milk in the living room, right?
No.
7 years later.
Oh, yeah.
Neither has changed.
Too late now, Mom.
Gabby is 10 years old now.
So go ahead, everybody.
And
this
a fifth
is your
grader at Big Lakes Liberty Elementary.
Gabby, how's it going?
Good.
Okay. It looks very colorful.
The eye-protecting swim goggles are gone, except when she sleeps. But that viewing machine is her daily companion because Gabby is legally blind.
Look at me.
Gabby's left eye was removed and replaced with a non-functioning prosthesis not long after this 2004 eye clinic visit.
Give me 5 for doing so good.
As a toddler, doctors had sewn shut both Gabby's eyes for her own protection. Too young to know better and with no pain to tell her to stop, Gabby had nearly blinded herself, scratching her eyes with her own fingers.
Helps me see the smart board.
Gabby's insensitivity to pain has also cost her most of her teeth.
There's 4 more in here.
Those she didn't break off biting toys were removed after she began mutilating her tongue and mouth, unaware of another child like Gabby in the country.
Watch your head, sweet pea.
Is it any wonder that 7 years ago...
I'm going to put it on the same plate as pancakes. Is that okay?
Gabby's parents felt so desperate and alone.
There are no support groups. There are no emails or no websites. There are no parents who can tell us what we might expect. Nothing.
She had a broken jaw and you didn't even know it.
Turns out alone.
Her body actually feels no pain at all.
Was a temporary state.
Your daughter does not feel pain.
The media has actually been our best friend over the years of really starting to connect us to people. And then our second best friend now is Facebook.
These past 7 years, Trish and Steve Gingras have connected with 60 other families around the world who share Gabby's condition.
These are just some of the topics we've been talking about lately. Hon, I have to read you one. I cannot believe I'm actually grateful my daughter cannot feel the bite and bruise created when another child bit her arm on the bus.
Emily and Jordan, let's lead the way.
I don't think we'd be able to imagine where we are today back then.
He was like a little skinny prune when I saw him.
She has a lot of friends. She goes to regular school and she's doing great there. Better than I ever did. So really, we're pretty happy where we are.
I know you. I walked with you once upon
a little girl who once danced with princesses has changed slippers.
The best thing.
And now sings with Taylor Swift. Her parents have hoped for surgery that may one day improve vision in Gabby's remaining eye.
It's really soft.
While Gabby has her sights set elsewhere.
And my chin is a little jutted out.
By age 16, she'll be old enough for dental implants so Gabby can look.
I just feel regular.
Exactly the way she feels.
I just feel normal like any other kid.
Gabby, can you set the table?
Gabby faces a daily threat from the aches, sprains, and burns that tell the rest of us to see a doctor or back away from physical threats.
Everything is very, very hot, so let it cool for
a minute. I will.
Gabby still feels no pain. But in every measurable way.
Is it okay?
Yeah, it tastes awesome.
Gabby and her family are feeling better.
So did you have fun at school today, Gabby?
Yeah.
Katie will never have a date eating with her fingers.